Welcome to my YouTube channel, Lifestyle Tutorials. Today's topic of discussion is how to generate a PayPal bank statement of all your activities via PayPal. What you need, this is a business PayPal. Business PayPal means it's a PayPal that has a lot of capability. One thing, the capability, when we come to activity, we'll be able to generate those reports. The reports. The essence of here, we can search a certain transaction. Since it's a business PayPal, it means maybe we can automate. Maybe I can have 100 employees and I need to search a certain transaction. Maybe like the Jumia or those big companies. I need to search a certain transaction so that to verify if it went through or it never went through. Or maybe I have 100 customers who came to my shopping account and they transacted, and I need to search a specific. Through this search bar, you can be able to search for a specific transaction. Maybe a client who is disputing something can send you the transaction number and you'll be able to get them. Then the other query that we are able to use using PayPal is this activate. We can be able to scrutiny to get all the transactions. When we are generating a business statement of the PayPal account, we can be able to, here we'll pick all, but we can only pick the transactions that were archived. It tells me that I can only pick the transaction that I can query only the archived or the active ones. Here now this statement will query all. Then in all the transaction, we can query maybe the balance affecting. Maybe only the transactions that have the payment received. Only the transactions that have the payment sent. We can query maybe all the invoices, the unpaid invoices. Maybe somebody is a supplier of goods, and you already sent invoices to companies, and you really need to know the number of companies that have paid and those that have not paid. Now you will be able to query the invoices that have paid and the ones that have unpaid. But for today, we'll query all the transactions. We can query all the currencies. If there are different people from different continents, it's possible to say you only need those people who have paid using US dollars, or you need maybe those people who have said using Japanese yen. Then you also need to limit. Like for today, we limit it to 2019. We want all the transactions that have been carried out in 2019. Then we will press download. Once we press download, we will get that statement. We'll get the PayPal statement of all the transactions that have been carried out. When we press download, it will take us to there. Yeah, internet is taking some time to load, but in a minute it will be ready. Here it is. Yeah, we can be able to get the balance. You have created and download a detailed report of all the transaction activity in any period in the last seven years. You can be able to scrutiny, query, or filter all the transactions that have been done in the last 7 years the way you want them. As I've said, I can query only the completed payments or the balance that is affecting the total balance. Our total balance is zero. So in case maybe here we can see we have a pending transaction. The moment it was $142, we can generate the balancing affecting the total balance. But here we'll filter all the transactions. Then we said we can filter with the date range, either since the last download, either for today alone, for yesterday. This one applies for business papers where maybe somebody has so many transactions and they need to query the transactions that had been done yesterday so that they may use that PayPal statement to file them for future records. Either we can, for today, we'll scrutiny for the past 3 months. We see the transactions that have been carried out. We can get the format that the statement is going to come. We can get it in CSV. Either we can get in tabs or PDF, but today we'll have to choose PDF, then we'll create a report. Once we create a report, we say, your request has been processed. and we will email you when the report is ready to download. In certain cases, it might take longer depending on the period and the volume and the capacity. Let us go to the email address and find and see if they have really emailed us. Let us confirm. Yeah, we should have received. Yeah, here is the email update. It tells me that your activity report is ready. Then we'll be able to get the report. We requested it in PDF format. Yes, we'll come here and say download the report. Once we click download the report, we'll be able. Yeah, here is the report. Here is the report in here. We have seen this is the downloaded PDF. It shows the transaction history from September 1st to November 30th. As we went we had scrutinized only the transactions that have been done for the last 3 months, and you'll be able to generate them. This is very important, especially for people who are using large scale business, who normally have many transactions per day. Since you maybe want to store your data in a certain format, people will be there. We can also review the we can get fine the financial summaries. We can also get those are the statements. We can customize statements by the end of the month. We are sent automatically. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Lifestyle Tutorials. Thank you for sticking with me. Today's topic of discussion was how to generate a PayPal statement that has all your transactions. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Lifestyle Tutorials. Subscribe, like,